If you follow this channel for a while, you know that varroa mites today are the number one enemy of honeybees. However, what you might not know is that varroa, it's not the most destructive honeybee pest that we know. The amount of damage caused by American Foulbrood in the early 20s in the United States was terrifying. It was a big deal at the time. For you to have an idea of how impactful this disease was, the state's beekeeping inspectors program and beekeeping associations started because of American Foulbrood epidemic. People really felt the necessity to get together to fight back against this lethal disease. Today, the inspection program, together with stringent regulations and intense use of antibiotics, was able to keep American Foulbrood under control. In this video, I will explain why American Foulbrood is still a very dangerous disease that we must take seriously, and show you a new tool coming to the market that will help you to keep this important disease and perhaps many others away from our honeybee colonies. The causative agent of American Foulbrood is the gram-positive spore-forming bacterium Penibacillus larvae. The endospore of this bacteria are the only infectious form of this organism and can only infect larvae. Adults don't become infected. It works like this. Larvae from 12 to 36 hours old are most susceptible to infection. If their food is contaminated with about 10 spores or less, that's enough to initiate a fatal infection. What is a fatal infection, you might ask? The bacteria will colonize and massively replicate in the midgut of honeybee larvae and slowly find their way into the gut, where they penetrate the gut epithelium, reaching all other tissues of the new honeybee. The rapid propagation of the bacteria together with the release of power proteases are responsible not only for the killing of the larvae, but for the degradation of the remains, something that we know is a brownish, semi-fluid thing, a classic symptom of American Foulbrood that we call a ropey stage. Here is the danger of American Foulbrood. The spores remain infectious for more than 35 years and withstand severe weather and drought, and it is resistant to antibiotics. This kind of organism is a constant pressure to beekeeping operations because we know they're just there all the time waiting for the right opportunity to cause damage. Because of the rapid damage American Foulbrood epidemic can cause, American Foulbrood is a notifiable disease around the world, regulated by law, which includes the destruction of clinically infected hives, causing significant losses for the beekeeping operation that needs not only to burn part of the colonies, but also to quarantine part of the operation. Antibiotics are often used to prevent and treat colonies. Not legal. However, as you probably know, severe problems are associated with the use of antibiotics. For example, antibiotics kill the replicating bacteria but not the spores, only suppressing the clinical symptoms for a short period of time and masking the disease but not curing them. Number 2. Chemical residues from antibiotics can persist in honey, affecting its quality and safety for human consumption. Number 3, antibiotics affect the vitality of the brood and the longevity of the honeybees. And number 4, the problem with bacteria resistant to antibiotics, which creates superbugs. So the use of antibiotics is, to say the least, a bad choice. Another way beekeepers try to deal with American Foulbrood is by a genetic selection of hygienic honeybees. If you want to have a taste of how complicated and controversial this might be, please check my videos about hygienic behaviors and make your own conclusions. At the end of the day, what is really keeping American Foulbrood under some sort of control is the constant monitoring by apiary inspectors and stringent laws requiring beekeepers to burn infected colonies. And even with all of that, there are still occasionally severe events happening, and this is underreported because of fear. The system is able to suppress the problem, but the pressure is always there. Other industries are able to prevent diseases effectively, using vaccines. Something that, until recently, was not possible in the beekeeping industry. And that is where Dalon Animal Health comes in, bringing to the market soon the first ever honeybee vaccine. Recent events were a strong reminder of the importance of vaccines. Vaccines have the power to improve lives and change industry, and hopefully, now, we might have a new tool to help honeybees against pests and pathogens as well. Dalon, we will start with the vaccine against American Foulbrood, and it works like this. A newly mated honeybee queen is introduced in a queen cage together with assistant workers. Nothing new here. What is new is the food that we receive, a normal queen candy mixed with the vaccine. Super simple. The assistant bees will then feed the queen with food from this candy, vaccinating the queen. And small pieces of dead American foulbrood bacteria will end up in the fat bodies of honeybee queens. And this way, the whole new generation of honeybees from the vaccinated honeybee queen will receive the necessary immunity to fight the disease. A process called transgenerational immune priming. And did I mention that it's non-GMO and can be used in organic beekeeping operations as well? Pretty cool, huh? Dalon is working to get the green light from the regulatory agency, the USDA in this case. Yes, all data Dalon generated on safety, manufacturing, and efficacy is being reviewed by a regulatory agency like any other animal vaccine you would get from your veterinary, so that beekeepers can now start using in their hives. Please visit dalon.com for more information. Link in the description of this video. Dalon is very excited to bring this innovation to reality, and I am very proud to be part of this impressive team. Meaning that I will be talking a lot about this new technology here in this channel, and if you want to follow along, this is a good time to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell, and become officially an InsideTheHive.tv insider. It is always great to have you here. Thanks for watching InsideTheHive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to the channel and also supporting us on Patreon. I also want to invite you to watch this next video right here. Thanks for watching InsideTheHive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.